Hey everybody, it's Wednesday again, so this is Steve here. Welcome for the Midweek Challenge, and I'm glad you're here for that. So I'm going to start out today with a question, and the question is simply this. What bugs you? I mean, really bugs you. Maybe it's something small. Maybe it's, you know, you live and work in downtown Houston, and you want an In-N-Out burger for lunch, and, you know, Houston doesn't have an In-N-Out burger yet, and you are just bummed at that, you know? What bugs you? And you could share that below. Maybe it's something really, really big that just it bugs the snot out of you. Now, for me, I'm going to be honest. Last week was kind of a wash for me because I was really bugged about everything that's going on in the social, political, media hype. It's just chaotic. Now, if you know me, if you follow me, if you read the book that I wrote last year, I talk about the fact that I've really been able to move away from a lot of this, but last week was just bad. Last week was a wash for me. One of those days where I read this link and then I watch this video and then one thing goes on to another and it just got more and more depressing. And I was so bugged about everything that's going on in the political drama in our culture today until the redeeming moment came about Thursday morning last week when I was on the treadmill. And I think God reminded me of what Paul said in Romans chapter 12, verse 21. Well, what did Paul say in Romans chapter 12, 21? I'm glad you asked. Paul made this observation that we are not to be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Now, I've known that verse for a long time, but it was a reality check, coming back to this reality of the bigger picture of everything. And I thought, I need to add that to my life verses. Not being overcome by evil, but overcoming evil with good. So we're going to talk about good, and there are three goods that I'm going to give you for the challenge today. Here's the first one, and that's simply to see the good. See the good. Here's what I mean by this. There's so much negativity out there. All of the messages are about the evil, about the bad, and there are some real issues, but we forget the good. For me, one of the beautiful things is to remember just the beauty of God's creation. So the application to see the good, I want to challenge you today, before you go home today, before you go to bed today, I want to challenge you to make a list of top 10 goods. Just write them out. What are 10 good things in the world today? So the first one is see the good. The second thing, there we are, second thing is to thank the good. Here's what I mean about this. Just look around at those who have brought good into your life. Maybe you've been married for a while, and your spouse has been faithful to you. You know, we live in a culture with a whole lot of infidelity. And if your spouse has been faithful to you, just thank them for that. In your work environment, there's a whole lot of cutthroat mentality going on, whether it's education, business, corporate, or whatever. And if you work with some people where it's about the team, thank them for that. Thank them for being concerned about the team and not just themselves. And then to thank God. Here's one for me. I love music. I love all kinds of music, except, well, maybe not country western. But a lot of times, I just thank God for music. I thank God that I have ears and I can hear music. And it just acknowledging that God's brought that good into my life. So number one, see the good. Number two, thank the good. Number three, do the good. Much of everything that's going on in the political, social media, and all that business is about what others are doing wrong and how bad they are because they're not doing what we think they ought to do. It's all about pointing fingers at someone else. So the challenge with do the good is what can you do practically right now? Maybe you are out at having lunch with somebody during the midweek challenge. Why don't you Why don't you buy their lunch today? Do good for someone else. When you get home and the kitchen's dirty, don't wait for, another member of the family. You do it. What can you do good for someone else today? And many people are involved in a local church. And a lot of times we look at the church and we ask, what can this church do for me? The challenge is, what can you do good for the church. So again, it's see the good, think the good, and do the good. And I'm going to do some good for you right now. Now, many of you know that last year I wrote the book, Confessions, Finding Hope Through One Pastor's Doubt. And here's the good. I've got another code where you can get a free download of the Audible version of Confessions. So the first person that will direct message me or email me and say, dude, I want the book, I will get you a code so you can get the Audible version of Confessions. So as we wind down, again, see the good, thank the good, do the good. And I'd request, as always, if you like these, if these are good for you, helpful for you, then share them with others. Follow the Kingdomology blog, the Facebook, the Twitter, and all of that. Be strong, and I'll see you again next Wednesday.